Chris Stewart and Stewart Partners Limited, farmers and contractors, and we're down in Devon near Exeter. Mixed farm, arable and beef on our own, and general contracting along with share farming and contract farming. And we currently run a class 770 combine along with various other class bits of equipment, forager, balers, rakes and tedders. But we've been running Lexian combines. We had our first 450 in 1997, then went to have a second one in 98, and then we moved on to the 480, replacing two for one, and have been running the rotary since the year 2000. Moved on through all the models. We've, like I said, on our current model, the 770. One of the major factors was when we went to the 480, was going to tracks, so not just the rotary, but it was also having tracks, which transformed it in our part of the world here on the steep banks. It's like having a four-wheel drive, while also keeping the transport width narrow for us, and it replaced what we happened to run before, was having to run dual wheels. So it was a big step forward for us. Obviously we ran the straw walker combine for three seasons. We had two walkers, and we wanted to rationalise the business and go back to a single combine. And the rotary was the way to go, but in obviously in Devon, straw quality is a major factor, and there's a lot of people who were concerned that we would overthrash and damage the straw. Having had a previous experience with axle flow combines in the 80s, but having looked and seen the 480 work in the field, we were pretty convinced that we could manage the straw quality, and that certainly has been proven. The straw has not been an issue. Of course you can thrash it if you want to, but you actually don't need to. And that's been the great thing with the class rotary. One of the biggest step forwards we saw over the rotary life that we've been involved with was when we went to the 480 Evo, and we're having a variable rotor speed. Again, following on from straw quality, this gave us a lot more flexibility on thrashing the straw and a lot bigger increase in output. And because you can then change the rotor speed from the cab, you can do it easily. We would change it all day long, every day. And this is something that carries on to this day. Yeah, we went to Lexian 600 in 2006, and one of the major steps again in the evolution was the introduction of the Jetstream sieves. For us in our part of the world with a lot of banks, the sieves very often was the limiting factor in output, and Jetstream completely transformed this, whereas to this day now the sieves no longer limit output. It's more power and rotor losses, which is where we wanted to be. Yeah, and we're now on our second 770, and since we've run the 770 combines, we've been on the Vario 1050 header. It's something I describe it like going from a boy's header on the previous 900 to a man's header on the 1050. We got to a stage where the header was very much the limiting factor with output, and the 1050 has completely changed that around again. Not just because of the width, but actually because of the split auger and the twin drive knife. It's just been a big improvement, and it stopped the header being a limiting factor.